أشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد، وانتشت روحي وصار الدمع يجري، يا إلهي خذ بقلبي للرشاد.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على خاتم المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. إن شاء الله we will study together chapter number 10 from the book of بلوغ المرام من أدلة الأحكام for the Imam الحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله. Chapter number 10 is about menstruation or in Arabic الحيض. What is the definition of menstruation or الحيض؟ In Arabic we say الحيض في اللغة السيلان. In the language the word حيض means flowing, a flow of some fluid, some kind of fluid flowing. And we mean it here in the fiqh flowing of the blood coming from the woman, not because of a disease or not because giving birth. So this blood or flowing of the bleeding of the woman we call it حيض or menstruation. When the time, when the girl starts to have menstruation, so many scholars they say the girl can start to have menstruation or a period from the age of 9. And when we say age of 9, it is not 9 according to the solar system, according to the lunar system. So from 9 years old any girl can reach the age of puberty and have a حيض or menstruation period. And this is one of the signs of puberty for women, الحيض. Now excuse me. If a girl saw a blood coming from her before 9 years, this is not a menstruation, this is not حيض, it's some kind of disease. Okay, but I said when the حيض can start. Now the other question, when the حيض for women can end, at what age the menstruation period ends? There is no limit, no limit. Some women in their 40s they stop having menstruation, some in 50s, even some in 60s. So there is no limit when it will stop. Now, how can we recognize the color of the blood of menstruation? The blood of the coming from menstruation could be first, could be black or dark, very dark, like black. And this is because of the hadith. And this is the first hadith mentioned in this book. عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت إن فاطمة بنت أبي حبيش كانت تستحاض، فقال لها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن دم الحيض دم أسود يعرف، فإذا كان ذلك فأمسكي عن الصلاة، فإذا كان الآخر فتوضئي وصلي. رواه أبو داود والنسائي وصححه ابن حبان والحاكم. In English, the narrated Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that Fatima bint Abi Hubaysh had a prolonged flow of blood. And Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told her, the menstruation blood is a dark, recognizable blood. So if that comes, then avoid prayer. And if it is the other, it means light color, colored blood, then perform wudu or ablution and offer a prayer. For that is blood of a vein. And this hadith is reported by Abu Dawood and Nasa'i and Ibn Hibban and Al-Hakim. Graded it a sahih or a sound hadith. So this is from this hadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned one color of the blood of menstruation. It could be black, but also the color of the menstruation blood could be red color, because the redness is the original color of the blood. The third color can be menstruation blood, as-sufra, or a yellow fluid, yellowish color. This yellowish color could be a sign of menstruation period. Also, al-kadara in Arabic, or something between black and white, what we call it a muddy color, muddy color. So these are the four colors the blood of menstruation could come with it. The second point, second hadith, عن حمنة بنت جحش رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت كنت أستحاض حيضة كثيرة شديدة، فأتيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أستفتيه، فقال إنما هي ركدة من الشيطان، فتحيضي 6 أيام أو 7 أيام ثم اغتسلي، فإذا استنقأت فصلي 24 أو 23 وصومي وصلي، فإن ذلك يجزئك، وكذلك ففعلي كل شهر كما تحيض النساء، فإن قويت على أن تؤخري الظهر وتعجلي العصر ثم تغتسلي حين تطهرين وتصلين الظهر والعصر جميعا، ثم تؤخرين المغرب وتعجلين العشاء ثم تغتسلين وتجمعين بين الصلاتين فافعلي، وتغتسلين مع الصبح وتصلين. قال وهو أعجب الأمرين إلي. رواه الخمسة إلا النسائي وصححه الترمذي وحسنه البخاري. The translation of this hadith narrated Hamna bint Jahsh. May Allah be pleased with her. Hamna bint Jahsh, brother and sisters, she is the sister of Zainab bint Jahsh, the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Hamna bint Jahsh radiallahu anha, she said, my menstruation was too much and severe. So I came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask for his opinion. He said, this is a stroke of the devil. So observe your menses for 6 or 7 days. Then take a bath. And when you see that you are purified and quite clean, pray for 23 or 24 days and fast and pray for that will suffice you. And do so every month, just as the other women menstruate. But if you are strong enough to delay the Dhuhr prayer and advance the Asr prayer, then take a bath and combine the Dhuhr and the Asr prayer. Then delay the Maghrib prayer and advance the Isha prayer. Then take a bath and combine the two prayers. Do so and take a bath at a Fajr. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of the two types of actions, he said, this one appeal more to my liking. And this hadith mentioned by the five scholars of hadith except An-Nasa'i, and Tirmidhi reported it a sound hadith, and Al-Bukhari graded it at a hasan hadith. It means a good hadith. Now this hadith needs explanation. Hamna bint Jahsh, she came to the Prophet ﷺ telling him that her menstruation was too much and severe. Then the Prophet ﷺ, he told her, this is from shaitan, it's right from devil or shaitan. Then only you should stay 6 or 7 days. And this is the most days of menstruation for most women, from 6 to 7 days. And after that, you take a bath. And after that, you become pure. You can pray, fast, everything. But still, you have to make a wudu for each prayer. Still, you have to make a wudu for each prayer, because this, the bleeding, even it is istihada, we call it prolonged bleeding or istihada, it will break the wudu. But you don't have to take a bath. This is the first opinion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But he told her in the end of hadith, فَإِنْ قَوَيْتِ, if you are strong enough, if you are strong to do a bath after you can delay the Dhuhr and advance the Asr prayer. It means delay the Dhuhr till the end of the time of the Dhuhr and do the Asr in the beginning of the time of the Asr. Take a bath and do Dhuhr and the Asr. The Dhuhr in the end of the time of Dhuhr and the Asr in the beginning of time of Asr. And for Maghrib and Isha, do the same thing. You delay Maghrib till the end of the time of Maghrib and the beginning of Isha. And do Maghrib and take a bath and do Maghrib and Isha. And at the time of Fajr, take a bath and do Fajr. If you can do that, and the Prophet said, this is, I like this more. So from here, we, if you are strong enough to do it, you can do it. But it is not farther to take a bath, each two prayers. It is not compulsory. It is not must. But it is recommended. If you can do it, if you are in the situation of Hamna bint Jahsh, رضي الله عنها. But in both opinions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, you have to make wudu for each prayer. And the woman have a prolonged bleeding, it means istihada, she should not make wudu a long time before the prayer, because you know she is bleeding all the time. So you have to just make the wudu just before the prayer and go to do the prayer and put something after you do the wudu, you put something inside you to stop like a cotton to prevent the blood from flowing outside, and you do that. Okay, about the mustahada or the woman in a prolonged menstruation bleeding, there are three cases. There are three cases. What is the first case? If you know your period, how long usually it stays, your period 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, whatever, you know yourself before this happened to you, before istihada comes to you, you know your period, usually it was certain days. Then after these certain days, the rest, the bleeding, we call it istihada, it is not menstruation, it's prolonged bleeding. And then you take your shower and apply the rule. And the rule I mentioned, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave us two rules. The first rule, that after we take a bath, everything become halal to you. Your husband can sleep with you. You can pray. You can fast just like a regular woman. But for prayer, you have to make a wudu for each prayer. The other solution, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned that you delay Dhuhr and Asr. You take a bath, but for Dhuhr and Asr, you take another bath, delay the Dhuhr till the time of Asr, and take a bath to Dhuhr and Asr. Then delay Maghrib till the time of Isha, do Maghrib and Isha combined together, and then on the Fajr time, take another bath and do Fajr. If you can do that, it is recommended, but not obligatory. I mentioned the first case of the woman have istihada or prolonged bleeding. If the woman, she knows her period time, but what about if the woman, she doesn't know her period time? Because she forgot, or maybe she just started to have a period, she doesn't have experience before, you know, so what she have to do, she have, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Hamna bint Jahsh radiallahu anha, to stay only 6 days or 7 days. Consider your period just 6 or 7 days, okay, and the rest of the days you are not in a menstruation case. It's istihada, it's prolonged bleeding. You apply one of the two rules which I have mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now the third case of the woman, that the woman, she knows to distinguish between the blood of the menstruation and the blood of prolonged bleeding. She can differentiate between the color of the menstruation period, al-hayd, which is the color is black, dark, from the other color, which is of the bleeding or istihada, which usually the color of istihada, it is light red. So you consider yourself in a menstruation if the blood is black or dark, and if the blood is light red, this is istihada. You are not in a menstruation period, you are not in a hayd case, and then you just take a bath and apply one of the two rules which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has mentioned. So second حديث أو next حديث عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها أن أم حبيبة بنت جحش شكت إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الدم، فقال امكثي قدر ما كانت تحبسك حيضتك ثم اغتسلي. وكانت تغتسل لكل صلاة رواه مسلم. narrated عائشة رضي الله عنها that أم حبيبة بنت جحش. This is another sister of زينب بنت جحش. أم حبيبة بنت جحش is the sister of زينب بنت جحش, the wife, the mother of the believers, the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. She complained to Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم about the blood which flows beyond the menstruation period. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, keep away from prayer the length of time that your menses prevented you, then take a bath and offer prayers. And she used to take a bath every prayer. This hadith reported by Muslim. So the last sentence, it is not part of hadith that she used to take a bath each prayer. The Prophet did not tell her to do that, but she used to do that. So she followed the second opinion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that it is preferable for a woman in this case to take a bath each prayer if you are strong enough to do that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said فَإِنْ قَوَيْتِ, if you are strong, if you can do it, but it is not a must. Okay, now I will talk about something women usually be confused about. They always fluid or a muddy color fluid comes from the woman. What is the situation of the rules of this yellowish fluid or muddy color fluid? أم عطية رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت كنا لا نعد القدرة والسفرة بعد الطهر شيئا, رواه البخاري. narrated أم عطية, may Allah be pleased with her, she said we considered it nothing as impure, the muddiness and yellowness of the fluids after purification from menstruation, reported by Al-Bukhari and Abu Dawood. In the narration of Aisha رضي الله عنها, yellow and dusty colored water is considered as menses, but this hadith states we considered it nothing. There is no contradiction between what Aisha said and what Umm Atiyya said. How? If this yellow fluid or muddy color fluid happened during your period time, then still you are in a period, still you are in a menstruation period. But if it happened after your period time or after your menstruation period time, after you purified yourself, your period time finished, and you saw something yellow fluid or muddy colored fluid comes from you, this is nothing. This is nothing. You still pure. Okay, so we have two things. If this yellow color, you see it during your time of your period, you still in a period time. You consider it part of the menstruation period. Okay, but if this happened after your period finished and you purified yourself, and after the time, you know your time, 6 days, 7 days, you took a shower, and after that, after 2 days, you see you saw a yellowish color or muddy color, this is nothing. Okay, so there is no contradiction between the hadith, because the first hadith of Aisha, she was talking about if this yellow color happened during your period time. Hadith Umm Atiya, she was talking about after tahr, after purifying yourself. So there is no contradiction between the two hadith. I hope everything is clear. Is it clear? Okay, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Now, we know what is the rules for the woman in a period time, during her period time, what is, okay. Also, I did not talk about the woman, she gave a birth, same rules. The woman gives a birth, the same rule will apply for the woman bleeding because of delivering a baby, what we call it puerperal or blood or postnatal blood. Postnatal blood. So about the woman, she giving birth, even if she discourage the baby, still the rules apply for her. There is no a certain limited time to stay away from prayer or fasting. Since if the blood stopped from the woman gave birth or discouraged, if the blood stopped even one day or 2 days, 3 days, then she has to take a bath and pray, okay, and fast and do everything. The maximum is 40 days. The maximum is 40 days. This is the maximum, but there is no minimum. Some women, they give birth and same day their bleeding will stop. No bleeding anymore. Then she has to take a bath and do the prayer. Okay? So there is no minimum. Not you have to stay 40 days, because so many women, they understand that they have to stay 40 days. No, it is wrong. 40 days is a maximum. After 40 days, if you are still bleeding, we call it istihada or prolonged blood bleeding. And then the rules of istihada will be applied for you. And this emphasized by Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, كانت النفساء تقعد على عهد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد نفاسها 40 يوما رواه الخمسة إلا النسائي واللفظ لأبي داود. Narrated Umm Salama radiallahu anha, during the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the women having bleeding after delivery would refrain from prayer for 40 days, reported by the five except An-Nasa'i, and it is these words came from Abu Dawood. Okay, as I said, it means the maximum period of puerperal blood is 40 days, and the minimum time for it is not fixed. Okay? So there is no minimum, but there is a maximum. Okay, what is now forbidden for a woman in a haid, or what we call it nifas, giving birth, bleeding because of giving birth? What it is the rules for women in this case? First, she cannot fast. It's forbidden for her to fast. Extra fasting or month of Ramadan, she cannot fast. But if she missed a day from the month of Ramadan, she have to repeat it later, because Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, comes once a year. So she have to repeat the fasting, but not to repeat the prayers. What she missed from the prayers, because she cannot pray, she doesn't have to repeat what she missed in the prayers, because the prayers, it happened every day. So the Sharia, it is easy, and the Islam is easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful, he did not order the woman to repeat the prayers. So difficult. And every month she has to do that. But she has to repeat a sawm fasting. Okay? Also, it's forbidden for a husband to sleep, have a sexual intercourse with his wife if during her period time, or for a woman she delivered a baby and she's still bleeding. It's haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid that in the Quran. قال ولا تقربوا النساء في المحيط. Don't approach a woman during the menstruation period. But the man can enjoy anything of his wife except her private parts. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said it clearly. اصنعوا كل شيء إلا النكاح. Do everything with your wife except sexual intercourse. But you can enjoy the rest of her body and just avoid the private parts. Also, the woman cannot touch the Mus'haf, the Quran, in her period time, but she can read the Quran. She can read the Quran. Listen to this. A woman can read or listen to the Quran without touching the book of Allah. Okay? It is instead of the man in Janaba, if a man have to take obligatory bath because of a wet dream or sexual intercourse, he cannot even read the Quran because he have to go and take a shower. But this excuse for the woman because it's nothing to do with it. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she cannot miss reading the Quran for 7 days or 10 days or whatever. But for man, he have to take the bath right away. Okay, I think for a woman, last thing I will talk about, if a woman she went to do Hajj or Umrah, inshallah, I hope all of you, all of us will go, inshallah, for the people they did not go, and for even the people they went to go again and again. If a woman arrived there and she was in a state of ihram, then this is like Aisha, happened to Aisha radiallahu anha. I will say the hadith first. عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت لما جئنا صرف حطوا فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم افعلي ما يفعل الحاج غير ألا تطوفي بالبيت حتى تطهري. متفق عليه. Narrated Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, when we came to a place called Saraf or Seraf or Sarif. Okay, she said, I menstruated, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told me, do what a pilgrim does, except that you don't do every what a pilgrim does except that you don't go around making tawaf around the Kaaba until you are purified. And the hadith is agreed upon, means narrated in al-Bukhari and the Muslim. So it is not allowed for a woman in a state of her period time or giving birth to go around the Kaaba making tawaf a circulum about the around the Kaaba 7 times. She have to delay that till the end, till she became pure. But she can do anything else, making sa'y bin or walking between the mountain of Safa and al-Marwa, it's okay, and do everything, just the tawaf around the Kaaba or go around the Kaaba to delay it till she become pure from her period or her bleeding if she gave a birth. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم, and inshallah I ask
اشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد، وانتشت روحي وصار الدمع يجري، يا إلهي خذ بقلبي للرشاد.